Chapter 18. Wants and Needs. Dan leaned over to Mike and said, "I feel like eating a large pepperoni pizza." Feel like.
Feel like. To want to do something. To have a desire to do or have something.
Nick longed for his mother's cooking while he was away in the military. Long for.
Long for. To yearn for. To wish for something that one does not have.
After a long day at work in the factory, Jeff smiled and said, "I could go for a nice cold bottle of beer." Could go for.
Could go for. Would be happy to have. Would benefit from having something. Would be satisfied with.
Tim said that he is dying for something to eat. Be dying for, or to.
Be dying for, or to. To want to have very much. To long for.
As the three friends ran to the car, Cara shouted, "I've got dibs on the front seat." Have dibs on.
Have dibs on. To have a first claim on something. To have priority on.
Anthony told his parents that he would rather work in a factory and save money than go to school and spend it. Would rather.
Would rather. Would prefer something. Would like something better.
When Mark announced that he was gay, many people were shocked. But I have always said, to each his own. To each his own.
To each his own. Everybody has their own specific ideas or preferences. It is acceptable for people to like or believe in different things.
Chris had better go home early tonight because his wife is angry that he stayed out the night before. Had better.
Had better. Should. Ought to.
Sally has got to study all night if she is to have any hope of passing her test tomorrow. Have got to.
Have got to. Must. Have something essential to do. Be necessary to do.
Our company employees are supposed to be in the office working before 8:30 in the morning. Be supposed to.
Be supposed to. To be expected by others to do something. To have a responsibility or duty to do something.
Weekend conference. The last thing Gord felt like doing on the long weekend was attending a conference for work. He told his boss that he would rather let someone else take his place so he could enjoy spending the weekend with his family and friends. He was also dying to try out his new clubs on the golf course. But he thought he had better go to the conference instead because it's something he felt that he was supposed to do. As he sat in the first of five workshops, he longed for the days when he could leave work on Friday and forget about it until Monday. After the morning session of meetings was complete, Gord figured he could do with a large lunch. While waiting in line with some of the other middle managers, he called dibs on the only piece of roast beef he could see. When no one seemed to argue, he served himself the last portion of meat. The manager behind Gord leaned forward and said, "Gord, you have got to have patience in the food line. They'll bring us out a fresh platter of roast beef soon enough." Gord knew that patience was not his strongest attribute, and that maybe it would have been better if he had not come to the conference at all. Finally, he mumbled, "to each his own," under his breath, and decided to skip the rest of the conference and go golfing.